stop. Enough already. How are these black bars done? It's super easy, so black bars tutorial today. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Zdenka Darula. If you want to learn how to take better photos and videos with the latest gear and possibly participate in creative camera challenges, consider subscribing. I like to use those cinematic bars for many reasons. It helps me stylize the videos to make them look more interesting. I like it mainly for video sequence or B-roll. It's just very pleasing on an eye. It looks like in a movies. And then there is one more reason. No, I'm not gonna say it. Okay, I'm gonna say it. Fine, I'll say it. If I want to hide something, like for example, if I choose very dark background, too dark background, and my roots are kind of all grown out, and I just stretch the picture a little bit, I slap on the black bars and I hide it. Nobody sees anything. Reminds me, I still haven't found a volunteer in this house who's gonna help me with my hair this time. You know, male YouTubers have it so easy. They don't have to wear makeup, they just slap on the head and... Yeah, I tried it. Doesn't work for me. Moving on. So what is it? It's very simply a PNG file, an image. Two black bars and nothing between. There are tons of free PNG files online available for download. Thin black bars, thick. This way and that way, choice is yours. Let's go to Adobe Premiere Pro and do the whole animation. I'm just going to add this PNG file to timeline as another layer on top. This is how it looks like when it is at 100%. To make them come down and go away is super simple animation. I'll make them 132% size, that way they are gone. Click the keyframe. I'll click another keyframe where I want them to appear and shrink the size from 132% to 100%. Now they are here. To make them disappear again, I'll just do the opposite. Create keyframe at 100% as your starting point. And create another keyframe as your ending point. Change the size to 132% and done. Very simple. There are so many things you can do with them. You can make them flicker, you can do different colors, you can make them fade in, fade out. The possibilities are endless. You just need to use your imagination. Thumbs up if you liked today's video and subscribe to more. If you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hi, you can do so in a comment section below. By the way, all the tools I was using to create today's video are listed in the video description below. Feel free to check it out. Those are international links. Also, if you're interested in my LUTs and presets, you can visit my Patreon page. Again, the link is in the video description below as well. And I'll see all of you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.